Proverbs 27, verse 19. Proverbios 27, verso 9. Proverbs 27, 19 says like this. As water reflects the face, so one's life reflects the heart. As water reflects the face, so one life reflects the heart. Así como la agua hace una reflexión de tu cara, tu vida hace una reflexión de tu corazón. I can come over here in the water and I can reflect my face. Puedo venir acá al agua y yo puedo ver mi cara. According to Proverbs, chapter 27, verse 19, your life is a reflection of what's in your heart. Acuerdo a lo que dice Proverbios 27:19. Tu vida es una reflexión de lo que tú tienes en el corazón. I want you to look at the person sitting next to you right now. I want you to look them intensely in the eyes. Look at them. Look at the person sitting next to you. Look at each other. You guys reflect one another. You are a reflection of one another. If you know each other, if you live in the same house, you are a reflection. Si tú eres una, vives en la misma casa con una persona, ustedes tienen la misma reflexión. So when you look at that person, I want to ask you, do you like what you see? Tell the person next to you, I like your reflection. Tell the person next to you if you like the way they look. Si te gusta como se mira la persona a tu lado, dile, me gusta como te miras. Tell them that. Don't lie this morning. If you don't lie. Si no te gusta como se mira la persona a tu lado, no le digas una mentira. But you need to know something. You reflect each other. Tú eres una reflexión de tu esposa y tu esposa de ti. Because you both share the same character, the same moral, the same values, the same heart condition. Ustedes tienen las mismas morales, los mismos carácter, las mismas pensamientos sobre cosas políticas. Tienen la misma reflexión. And I want to tell you, if you don't like what that person's like, chances are you don't like yourself. Si no te cae bien esa persona, tienes que pensar, a lo mejor tú no te caes bien a ti mismo. By the way, there's no children's church. All the kids are here because they're watching Lion King. No hay escuelita ahorita para los niños porque los niños están mirando el Lion King, lo que estamos haciendo. So, normalmente los niños van a otra casa. Normally the kids go to another class. So I want you to ask the person sitting next to you. Ask them right now. How are you living? Pregúntale a la persona a tu lado, ¿cómo estás viviendo? Ask them, how you living? How are you living? ¿Estás viviendo bien? Pregúntale a la persona a tu lado, si estás viviendo bien. Brother Ruben said, I'm living in living color. That's what I heard Ruben say. He said, in living color over there. Is your life reflecting a good heart? Or is your life full of misery? Is your life full of darkness? Is your life full of drama? Chances are, your heart is the same thing. Si una persona tiene una vida buena, el corazón va a reflejar algo bueno. Pero si una persona está viviendo en oscuridad, si está viviendo pecado, si está viviendo con puros problemas, la reflexión del cuerpo, del alma, va a dar esa misma cosa. You are going to reflect from your persona what's in your heart. Some people have a dark heart. Hay personas que tienen un corazón muy oscuro. So tienen las facciones oscuras. There are persons whose ambience, whose projection is negative, because that's all that's in their heart. I love people who are happy no matter what. I love people that even though they had a bad day, they're still fun to be around. Yo conozco unas personas que, aunque están teniendo un día muy terrible, todavía esas personas son amistables, están alrededor de ellos. But there are some people that you can tell what kind of day they've had from the minute they walked through the door of the church. Hay personas que nomás entrando a la puerta de la iglesia, yo ya puedo ver qué clase de día tuvieron. But there's other people who, man, they're just happy, happy, joy, joy. Hay unas personas que tú no les puedes robar el gozo del alma, aunque tú trates, por más difícil que trates, porque están contentos, porque son hijos y hijas de Dios. There are people that are serving God. There are people that are loving God. That no matter how bad their life is, they're going to be happy. Who wants to keep you miserable? The devil. Who wants to keep you angry? The devil. Who wants to keep you depressed and sad? The devil. But the Bible says, they keep David wrote in the Psalms, Your heart should be soft. Your heart should be white as snow. Your heart should be tender. People should see on you how good your heart is. Debe de ser tu corazón limpio, blanco como la nieve. Debe de ser suave. Debe ser tierno. Que las personas pueden ver a Cristo en tu corazón. Because let me tell you, when people are miserable, when people are hating, when people are doing this and the other, that's a reflection of what's inside their heart. And I want to tell you something this morning. God never meant for you to be angry. God never meant for you to be sad. God never meant for you to be depressed. God never meant for you to be in anguish. God never meant for you to be suffering the way you are. God intended for you to be at peace. Dios entendió libertad. Dios no entendió que estuvieras enojado, deprimido, que tuvieras todo el tiempo triste. A reflection of who he is. Dios quiere que tú seas una reflexión de quién eres él.
Yes,
so, I want you to be honest this morning. If you had a bad day this week, one day this week, say amen.
Amen.
We all had a bad day. Cada uno de nosotros tuvimos un día esta semana que estuvo terrible. Un día terrible. Cada uno lo tuvimos. Well, all of you did. I had no bad days. I don't think I had a bad day. I had a bad hour or two. But for the most part, I had a pretty good week. Was my week difficult? Yes. Did I have some challenges? Yes. Were we short money? Yes. But guess what? I'm not going to let outside things affect what's inside of me. Yo no voy a dejar las cosas de afuera que afecten quién yo soy por dentro. Y saben qué, a ti nadie me puede robar el gozo. Nobody. Let me say it again. Nobody. Not even Sister Annie. Is going to rob the joy that's in my heart. Yo amo a esta mujer más que me amo a mí mismo, pero yo no voy a dejar que ella me robe el gozo de mi corazón. Every one of you, this, when we look at you, this is what we should see. Cuando miramos a tu cara, debemos de ver una sonrisa. Una sonrisa. I should not look at you and see. Pastor wore shorts. Where does he get off wearing shorts? Who does he think you are? Who does he think he is wearing shorts in church? ¿Qué se cree ese pastor? Mira, está usando pantalones cortos. Ahora yo voy a estar enojado toda la semana, todo el día, porque el pastor se puso pantalones cortos. There are people that's it. This pastor's crazy. He's the last time I wear shorts in here. That's it. You're going to let what somebody else is wearing bother you? Are you immature that you're going to let the clothes that somebody else is wearing bring you down? Hey, if they want to look like a fool, not me, but if they want to look like a fool, that's on them. Somebody said, well, that's what I was thinking, Pastor. Si esa persona se quiere vestir como un soso, déjalo. Psalm 32, verse 3 and 4.
Había un pedazo de metal acá arriba del flashing del techo que estaba colgando como los 10 pies.
And I've been waiting for a month that there would be another man in this church that would say, I need to fix that. Yo estaba esperando por un mes que hubiera un hombre aquí que dijera, yo tengo que poner eso. And you know why I didn't fix it for a month? Because I started wearing ties. Yo no lo había compuesto porque ya tengo un mes que me estoy poniendo corbatas durante el día. My wife says, you're about the dumbest pastor in town. All week you wear ties, now you're wearing shorts on Sunday morning. Dice mi esposa, corbata toda la semana y ahora se va a poner shorts el día de que va a predicar. I had to do this on Friday. 45 feet in the air. I had to hang over the edge of the church to my stomach. Tuve que colgarme desde el estómago arriba de la iglesia para estirar ese pedazo para arriba. When I got up there, my phone slid out of my holster. Mi teléfono se cayó de la cosita. And I caught it and I put it in my pocket. But I said, uh-oh, my phone would have made it. Dije yo, mi teléfono se hubiera quebrado. I should have let it go. The church would have had to buy me a new phone. Me había dejado que se cayera para que la iglesia me cobrara el teléfono, se prendió el phone. But what I did was, I said, Lord, I'm sorry for what I've done. Please forgive me for any sin I committed without knowingly. I'm sorry that I'm mad at Ruben right now, Lord. I'm sorry that I'm mad at this person and that person. Lord, forgive me. Pastor should not be angry. Now, I don't show you when I'm upset, but I show God. And that's why I share this with you. Cuando yo estoy oprimido, enojado, triste, trato de no soñar a ustedes, pero yo se lo enseño al Señor. Yo se lo enseño al Señor. And that's what you need to learn as people, is when that happens in your life, it's okay to go to God and confess those things. It's okay to tell God how you feel. In fact, I think you should do it. I think you have to do it. It's healthy to confess to God. The thing is, don't wear it all over your face for everybody to see. Let God see it. Todo el mundo no tiene que saber qué estás haciendo. I'm mad because I'm a living to see it. Todo el mundo no tiene que ver. Dios tiene que saber. Hay que confesarle al Señor y nadie más. We just confess to God, amen? Now, as Gabrielle and Angelique get ready, grab your microphones and jump up on the wall. Some people reflect their sinful life all over their face. They look guilty, they look like they have regret, they look like they have shame, they look like they're lost, they look dark, they look dead. Hay personas que pueden ver la culpabilidad en la cara, pueden ver el enojo, pueden ver la vergüenza, pueden ver que andan perdidos, hasta pueden ver la muerte en la cara. But that is not what God intended you to look like. Así no lo entiende Dios. The book of Genesis, it says God made you in His image. And the Bible says that God is without sin, so you should not be reflecting sin, you should be reflecting God. Si la Biblia dice que Dios nos hizo la imagen de Él, nosotros no podemos reflejar el pecado, tenemos que reflejar a Dios. Amen? We need to be reflecting God. Tenemos que reflejar a Dios. Now, don't fall off, please. We know that Adam was a reflection of God. The New Testament says that you and I, in 1 Corinthians 11:7, we are the image and the glory of God. 1 Corinthians 11:7. Sabemos que la palabra de Dios dice en 1 Corintios 11:7 que nosotros somos la imagen y la gloria de Dios. The person sitting next to you, the person sitting next to you is the image and the glory of God. Look at them. They look like God. La persona a tu lado es la gloria de Dios. Some of you thought, man, God, you got issues. No estén tan pensando, ¿qué pensó Dios? You're more than just who you are. You are more than just what meets the eye. You are an image and a combination of your father and your mother and all of your ancestors. Eres una combinación de tu Dios. Eres una combinación de tus familiares, de tu padre y de tu madre. You are a visual byproduct of your upbringing. You reflect your appearance, your morals, your faith, and your values. En tu apariencia podemos ver tus morales, tu fe y tus valores. You are an image of God. No matter how you live, even if you're in sin, you're still reflecting God. Aunque andes en pecado, todavía estás reflejando a Dios. Some reflect the true image of God, and some reflect a distorted image of God. Todos reflejamos a Dios, algunos malmente y otros buenamente. I want to ask you this morning. Are you reflecting a good God? Or are you reflecting something else? Are you not ready for it?
Hello?
Test. All right, you guys broke the rocks, all right.
Yes,
yeah. Oh, sorry, yeah. Manuel, you should be ready as soon as this is over with you and Ralph. These young ladies are going to try to introduce the story this morning.
Thank you.
there for me. But you're not. Because of me. It's my fault. It's my fault.
Son tus
familiares. Now, what you do matters because you reflect your family. How you act matters because you reflect your family. How you talk matters. It reflects on your family. ¿Cómo te portas? Lo que dices importa porque eres una reflexión de tu familia. Well, most of us here this morning have something that I want to call this morning your brown background. Every one of us almost, every one of us out here is comes from a brown background. We have a brown background. Cada uno de nosotros tenemos unos familiares cafeses. Para no ofender los salvadoreños, los puertorriqueños, los mexicanos, güey, cafeses. We all have in our ancestors some brown background. Now, let me tell you about your brown background. If you go back enough in your brown background, your brown background was out discovering the world when everybody else's background was fighting over one little continent. Did you hear that? Who do you think discovered America? Somebody in your brown background. Alguien de descendencia café descubrió las Américas. We come from a background of hardworking, adventurous people who took chances and went places nobody ever went. Tenemos unos en nuestra herencia, los que descubrieron a este continente. Whoever told you because you were proud, you could not go to college. They lied to you. In your back background, you were doing things that people weren't even dreaming about. Where is it that all these brown kids now, I ain't even gonna go to school today, Mom. Why? Because I'm Mexican. Mexicans don't go to school. Hay niños que no van a la escuela por el color de su piel. Somebody fooled you into thinking because you were brown that you didn't have the same opportunities everybody else had. But I'm gonna tell you something this morning. Because you are brown, you got inside you an adventurous spirit to go out and do more than anybody has ever done. Don't believe the lie. Fresno Unified has a horrendous track record for graduation. We graduate less than 60% of the kids that start high school in Fresno Unified. En nuestro país, en nuestro pueblo, menos de 60% de los que van a la escuela no van a graduar de la escuela. I don't know if you know that. And guess what? The majority color is in Fresno Unified. Brown. Hay más cafeses que cualquier otra raza in Fresno Unified. But per capita, the browns and the blacks have the less graduation rate. Los cafeses, nosotros y los morenitos tenemos menos graduando que los americanos. Why? Because some fool told somebody, because you're brown, you have less opportunities. I want to tell you something. In your brown background, are some adventurous people that didn't just sit there and say, I can't go that far on this ship because if I go any farther, I'm going to fall off the face of the earth. And they said, you know what? I'm going to go further than anybody's ever gone. I'm going to do more than anybody's ever done. Why? Because I represent something bigger than myself. I represent an ancestry of people who did great things, who worked hard, who respected, who worked for a living, and didn't just take what the government gave them. Just because you're Mexican doesn't mean you have to live on welfare. Just because you're Mexican doesn't mean you have to drop out of high school. Just because you're Mexican doesn't mean that you don't get to do this, that, or the other. Just because you're African American, just because you're Salvadorian or Puerto Rican, doesn't mean you can't do everything else that everybody else can do. I'm going to tell you something. There is no difference in how those little white kids and little brown kids put on their clothes in the morning. Each one of you has got to put your pants on one leg at a time. Unless you're wearing tight skinny jeans, you got to lay down and slide them on. Tenemos las mismas oportunidades. And let me tell you something. I'm tired of Hispanic kids embarrassing the brown people. Me estoy cansando de pasar vergüenzas con los jóvenes hispanos. You need to think about it, young people. You represent a brown people, a hardworking people. Let me tell you about your background. We populated all of California. We sold it to the gringos, and then we still live here. If you're gringo, please don't be offended today. Fuimos nosotros que descubrimos todo este país, de este lado de este país. Los que trabajamos los fines de este país somos gente que trabajamos dura porque representamos una cultura. You represent something bigger. You should be proud of who you are. You should be proud of where you came from. And you should do good. And for nothing else, you're a reflection on all of us. Haz un buen trabajo porque eres una reflexión en todos nosotros. Every time I see a Hispanic kid with his pants down here, his pants down here, yeah. Walking around like this, because he has his pants around like this. Así trae los pantalones, los mexicanitos, así, y así van caminando. Y los mira y dice, hey, órale. I walk up and say, hey, ¿cómo estás? ¿Dónde vienes? ¿Qué barrio? ¿Qué estás haciendo? I don't speak in Spanish, man. I got Spanish accent, but I don't speak in Spanish. Se portan como si son los más mexicanos y ni hablan español. Ni hablan español. What happened to our culture? Where did the brown people become the hardest working people and change over to the welfare people? ¿Dónde nos cambiamos de los que trabajan más difícil, los que hacen la cosecha, a los que reciben ayuda del gobierno? ¿Cuándo pasó esto? Who told these young people, this is all the opportunity you have? You come from a lazy people. Remember Pancho, that guy that was sitting like this with his hands? Okay, maybe I should try it right there. But there's this Pancho guy, he's sitting like this, he has the sombrero over his head and he's sitting down like this. Have you guys ever seen that statue? Y así están protegiendo al mexicano. Tiene un sombrero sentado así, la estatua. And they're trying to say that all Mexicans do is sit around and drink beer and have siestas. You know why that guy's sitting like that in your statue? Because he just got through working 8 hours in the sun and he's tired and he's resting. He's not sitting there because he's lazy. He's sitting there because he needs a breather. Young people, you come from a culture of respect. You come from an ancestry. We respect our mother and our father. And we don't talk bad to our mother and father. And we don't let anybody else talk bad about our mother and our father. Nosotros respetamos a nuestros padres y no dejamos que nadie más le falte respeto a nuestros padres. I never heard of a young Hispanic person disrespecting mom and dad. That's not acceptable. Why? Because when I offend my mom and my dad, I'm offending who I am. Yo no puedo ofender a mi madre y mi padre porque estoy ofendiendo quién soy yo. And I come from a heritage that respects elders. I am a reflection of Pedro Rivera from Monterrey, Mexico. Yo soy una reflexión de Pedro Rivera que nació en Monterrey, Nuevo León. He's a reflection of Teodófilo Rivera, who was born in Montemorelos, Nuevo León. I'm a reflection of my grandpa, Teodófilo Rivera, que nació en Montemorelos, Nuevo León. I'm also a reflection of Pedro Rivera, my great-grandfather, who was a horse racer in the Nuevo León ranchos. Soy una reflexión de mi abuelo, mi bisabuelo, que era un hombre que criaba caballos de carrera en México. I'm not some guy that just got off the boat. I'm not just some guy that just got off a train. I come from somewhere. I'm somebody. And I'm not going to embarrass where I come from. Yo no voy a dejar pasar vergüenza de donde yo vengo. Young people sitting here today, you need to be proud of who you are, but more proud of who you're going to be. Hay que tener orgullo sobre quién somos, pero ¿qué vamos a hacer? I here at this church will not tolerate any disrespect amongst the young people. Si yo miro un joven aquí faltando el respeto a alguien, I don't care if I get in trouble. I'm going to say something to them. Yo les voy a decir, hey, where we come from, we don't do that. No somos una cultura de faltar respeto. Why? Because we're a reflection of our God. Simba forgot who he was. He wasn't reflecting his dad anymore. He wasn't reflecting his ancestors anymore. And let me tell you something. When you're out there misbehaving, you just ain't a reflection of who your ancestors are. You're a reflection of this church. Cuando andan allá portándose mal y dicen que van a la iglesia, son una reflexión de la iglesia. 2 Corinthians 3:17. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Somebody say freedom. And we all, with unveiled faces, contemplate the Lord's glory. We are being transformed into His image, ever increasing, which comes from the Lord, who is Spirit. Usted y yo somos una reflexión de Cristo Jesús, que Él es la iglesia. When Paul was speaking to the church, he was reminding them, hey, you're supposed to be getting better. You're supposed to be transforming. You're supposed to be coming the glory of God, His bride, His church, without stain, without wrinkle. Le digo a la iglesia, deben estar sin ninguna arruga en la iglesia, sin ninguna marca. Ustedes son reflexión de la esposa de Jesús, la iglesia. Now, I'm going to tell you something. You need to think about that. The next time you get on Facebook, I'm just going to do it. Switch over to my laptop. I want to see these people, what they put on Facebook this week that I saw. Come on, turn it on. El hermano va a aprender aquí algunas de las cosas que algunos de ustedes dijeron en el Facebook esta semana. Quiero, it's going to take a little bit. I want to see, because there's some people here, you need to be ashamed of what you put on Facebook. You need to, everybody needs to call you out right here, right now. You should have never, ever asked to be a friend at Christian Temple, because I accepted it, and now I'm going to put up on here what you've been doing. How many of you are thinking, oh no, he ain't? Hay personas aquí que están sudando porque creen que voy a poner en la pantalla lo que ellos dijeron en Facebook. Hay personas ahorita que están temblando. I can see that they have their face down right now. I'm like, uh-oh. There are some things that some of you are saying on Facebook that I can't even put on that on there because I'm ashamed. And I'm very short. Han dicho algunas cosas personas aquí en el Facebook que yo no puedo poner allá porque me da vergüenza y yo traigo pantalones cortos. And finally, Exodus 34, 29 through 30. You are a reflection of God. Manuel, Ralph.
You are a reflection of God.
Seba said, but Dad, I made these mistakes. I can't go back. And he said, it doesn't matter. You are who you are, even though you've made your mistakes. Aunque has cometido errores, tu guía eres una reflexión de Dios. And I'm going to tell you this morning, you can just tell when somebody's been with God. They have a joyful expression. You can tell when they've been with God because all their pride and arrogance is gone. You can tell when they've been with God because their attitude is not the same. You can tell when they've been with God because you can tell that they're not of this world. Cuando alguien ha pasado tiempo con Dios, ya no son los mismos. Están más gustosos, ya no tienen orgullo, ya no tienen arrogancia, ya no tienen la misma actitud, se portan diferente porque son una nueva creación. I want to ask you this morning, can people tell that you've been with God? Now if you close your eyes right there where you're at, cada ojo cerrado, every eye closed. We're going to take communion this morning. Vamos a tomar la palabra.
Christian, everyone's pleasure. That doesn't matter.